I'm from New York. I live in New York City. I'm from Ohio originally.
Ditto.
And I'm interested in Black Mountain because my teacher and mentor and friend Ray Johnson went to school here once upon a time, and also, you know, other people I'm interested in like Cage and so on. And so me and three other people, Danielle Wyckoff, Astrid Kammerling, and Jonathan Creasy, are from three other places. And the four of us were put together to do a chance operation where we combine our forces, even though we don't know each other, to do a performance. So we've been like Skyping each other and communicating by email to create a installation. And this is what we came up with, and it has to do with words, communication. The name of it is Tracing Thoughts, Capturing Processes of Anti-Academic Artistic Research. So in other words, it's kind of like about the collision between artistic research and academic research, and the differences between them, and conflicts between them, and similarities as well. And it's mostly just about words, and we're going to perform words and phrases and sentences and letters and just deal with language and paper and communication. Does that make sense?
How do you feel your mentor influenced you for this installation?
Oh my God. Well, Ray Johnson was probably one of the most interesting people who used visuals and you know, words together, I think. He really integrated them. And he's like, he wasn't really called a poet, but I think he was really a poet. He's known as a visual artist, so he used words a lot. So in that way, it trickles down to me.
Because you know, words are both symbolic and have of meaning and can be interpreted multiple ways, or?
Well, I guess visual art could be thought of as a kind of language. And I think that words and letters could be thought of as symbols and pictures. So really, they're sort of the same thing, like they're different ends of the same spectrum, you know, like one is, well, what I just said, you know, what, you know, word, you know, letters, like, you know, this C is a, what is that? It's just a symbol, it's a picture of something, but to us it means something, you know, and then you put it together into a word like capturing, and then you really got something.
And you have blank paper here, and you have some letters.
Yeah, I'm going to paint
set up
on
here.
This. So what we're going to do is I'm going to paint on this. We're going to have like different areas, but they're all integrated into one. So I'm going to paint on it something like these letters. And I'm going to paint over there. And then we have our friend Astrid is going to do some spray painting up there. And then we have Danielle, and she's going to interact with the chalkboard over there. We have a chalkboard at the other end. And then we have a sound guy who deals mostly with sound, Jonathan, and he's going to, you know, provide a soundtrack for our piece, and he's going to do some of his poetry, which is over there on the windowsill. And yeah, just a lot, everything to do with language and writing and criticism and poetry and having fun with words, being serious with words. Words. Does that make sense?